What you see here is an AI agent that manages your Gmail inbox. I was able to set this up in about half an hour and I didn't have to do any coding. By the end of this video, you'll know how this works and you'll know how to set one up with your own email to manage your inbox. What it does is it watches for new emails, then it'll run them through this text classifier, and the AI model will classify your email into one of these three categories: high priority, support, or finance. By the way, you can update these categories based on any use case that you might have. Then there's a certain chain of actions that take place based on the category. For example, if it's classified as high priority, the email will be labeled in Gmail. Then the AI will generate a draft that will then be created in Gmail and will receive a Telegram message alerting us of this high priority email. So the reason we create a draft instead of sending this message straight away is because of it being high priority, we want a human in the loop to verify the AI generated message before sending it off. In these other cases, you can see we send a reply straight away and then still get a confirmation on Telegram. And before we start, I just want to preface by saying that this portion here was created in another one of my videos. If you want to go watch that, I'll leave a link in the description. The only difference is instead of these categories, we used high priority, medium priority, and low priority. So you can go ahead and watch that, because in this video, we're going to mainly focus on this portion of the workflow. And if you want this template for free, you can go to my free school community and download it there. We'll start off by doing a deep dive into the high priority section. What I'll do is send an email to the Gmail account that this trigger is watching and waiting for new emails to come into. In this email, I'll use keywords that will signify to the text classifier that this is a high priority email. You can see in this text classifier node, we write out each category, label, and its description. Obviously, the description helps to determine what each category means, and in turn will help to classify the emails into one of them. The description for high priority says, urgent or time-sensitive matters that require immediate attention. Examples include legal issues, critical bugs, client complaints, or deadline-related problems. So I'm going to copy this and go to ChatGPT. I'll say, write me an email that matches this classification. Then I'll paste it in. ChatGPT gives us the subject and the body of the email. We found a critical bug causing payment failures in production. So yes, that's definitely high priority and it should be labeled that way by our text classifier. So we'll copy this, paste it into Gmail, and we'll send this off. Then a few seconds later, we received the email. Back in NAN, let's execute the flow. So the trigger detected that new email. Then the text classifier, like I said, it has these descriptions, and you can see the high priority description is urgent or time sensitive matters. So it classified our email as urgent. It went this route and labeled our email with a high priority label. So back in Gmail, we can refresh and we see that the label was added. To find this node, you click the plus icon in the top right and you search for Gmail. You click it and then you search label. And then you choose add label to message. So the way this works is by targeting the resource, which is a message, and the operation is add label. Then the message ID is coming from that email that triggered this workflow. Okay, so the way we grab that is by going to the Gmail trigger and dragging in the ID from right here. For label names or IDs, you have to go in this list and select the label you want to add to that message. Now it's only going to give you a list of the labels you already have created in your Gmail. For example, these labels on the side, you have to have the labels already created in Gmail. Like you have to go in here and click create new label and add the label, right? Then if I go back to this list and refresh it, you can see that that label I just added is right here, okay? So make sure you have a high priority label in your Gmail, then you can choose it from this list. And on to our next step, we have the message model node. To get this node, you click the plus icon in the top right and search OpenAI, click it, and then you'll choose the message a model text actions node. Click into here, and we see a credential to connect with is needed. So I have videos on connecting your OpenAI account to these nodes. You can go and watch those videos before you continue here. And then for resource, we do text, operation is message a model, and then we choose the model from the list. And we're going to go with GPT 4.1 mini. It's a cheap model and it'll get the job done. This AI model will take the input from the email as the user prompt, and then it uses the system prompt, which is the instructions, to do the following. It says, you are a professional business assistant. You will be given the subject and text of a high priority email that requires an urgent and thoughtful response. Sign off as Kyle. What we're telling it to do is pretend it's a professional business assistant. We want it to act as if it's a professional. You will be given the subject and text of a high priority email. We're telling it what it's going to receive, and we're telling it what we require. It requires an urgent and thoughtful response. And we're also telling it to sign off as Kyle, which is my name, by the way. So your task is to write a clear professional subject line, and two, write a brief, polite, and action-oriented response addressing the issue. Output the following parameters. So we want the output to just be a subject and a message, so we're telling it to only output those parameters. And of course, we have to make sure it's in JSON format. So go down here and check this output content as JSON. If we look at the output, we can see the content is subject, like we said here, and message, like we also said here. The message is, hi team, thank you for bringing this to my attention. I understand the urgency and am available for a quick sync right now. Best, Kyle. So it knew what the content of the email was because here our prompt from the user is the subject of the email, which we get by going to the email trigger, collapsing the headers, and then dragging in the text from here, right? And also dragging in the subject like that. So now we have this beautiful output that goes directly to this draft tool. And to get this create a draft node, you click the plus icon, search Gmail, and then search draft, and you'll see create a draft. And the way this works is it connects to our Gmail account, the resource is draft, and the operation is create. So you drag in the subject to the subject field, and then down here you want the email type to be text, and you drag in the message right here. So that's going to send the draft, and in the drafts in my Gmail you can see it was created. So this is a great like starting point for your email. You know, you can put the recipient's name in here. I think we can actually set this up right now. We can add an option, send replies to, or to email. I think that's the one. And then we can go to Gmail trigger and find who it was from and put that in there, okay? And if we execute the step again, it should create another draft. And there we go. Now we have the recipient. And yeah, this is a great starting point. You can, you know, update this if you want or remove some stuff and then send it off. On my phone, I actually got a Telegram notification. You can see it here, Telegram. And I'll pull it up on the laptop so you can see it clear. We received an email from Kyle Friel. It was labeled as high priority. Here's our response. So the way we structure this in this node is like so. We connect to our Telegram account via the credential, then the resource is message, and the operation is send message, and then we reference the chat ID. I'll leave a video link telling you how to set up Telegram, and so you can set that all up in that video and then come back to this one. For the text and the message, we define it here. We say we received an email, and then we drag in the recipient name from the Gmail trigger output. So go down to from, and you drag in the name here. You could also drag in the email if you want, like so. And then we say it was labeled as high priority. Here's our response. And we take the subject and the text from our high priority draft node. And we drag these in, like so. So I hope you're starting to see how this works and you're getting a good grasp on how it's all pieced together. Next, we're going to go through the support section. So let's send another email. Again, I'm going to ask ChatGPT to structure that email for us. So let's go into the text classifier and see what the description is on the support category. Emails from customers requesting help, reporting issues, asking questions about products or services, or needing general assistance. And then paste it into ChatGPT. And ChatGPT gave us this wonderful email. It says, hi, I'm having trouble logging into my account. Can someone help me get access? So obviously this is a customer needing support. So our text classifier should classify this as customer support. We'll copy this and paste it into a Gmail email, and we'll just say the customer's name is Jill. Okay, and now we send this off. A couple seconds later, we got our email. Now we'll execute the workflow. It detected that email, the text classifier is working, and it's labeled it as a support email. So we'll go into the label node here. It's the same setup as the high priority, except instead of the label being high priority, we choose the support label. So make sure in your Gmail you have a support label created. Then you can choose it from this list. And again, you drag in the ID. And then in this case, we also have a message a model node that's using the same model, 4.1 mini. And this time we send in the subject and the text, just like last time. as the user role. And then for the system prompt, this is going to be a bit different. This one says, you are a professional customer support assistant. We want the agent to act as if it's a professional support assistant. You will be given the subject and text of a customer support email. We're telling it what it's going to receive and sign off as Kyle. Then we're telling it the task. Write a clear and friendly subject line for the reply. And then write a polite, empathetic, and helpful response that directly addresses the customer's concern and outlines any next steps or resolutions. Use a calm and reassuring tone and aim to leave the customer feeling heard and supported. We really want to emphasize to the agent to be a professional customer support assistant and be reassuring in its response. And again, we're telling it to output the subject and the message in separate fields in a JSON output. So again, make sure the output content as JSON is checked. And the message is, hi Jill, thank you for reaching out. I'm sorry to hear that you're experiencing trouble logging into your account. You can go ahead and read that, but yeah, that looks good to me so far. It's very reassuring. So the next tool we used was the reply. So unlike the high priority where we draft a reply, this node is actually going to send that message to the recipient. So to find this node, you have to click the plus and go to Gmail and then search reply. And you'll see reply to a message. Within the node, you'll need to make sure the resource is thread and the operation is reply. And then you'll want to drag in the thread ID. So you'll go to the Gmail trigger and you'll find the thread ID right here and you'll drag that in. And then message snippet or ID. So we'll drag in the message ID here. And email type needs to be text. And the message is going to be the output from our last node. So we drag in this right here, and there you go. So we're back in our Gmail. First of all, you can see it was labeled as support, and this response was automatically sent. So the response from the AI was automatically sent to this recipient. And then as I pull up Telegram, you can see we received an email from Kyle Friel. It was labeled as customer support, and a reply was sent. So if we go into the Telegram send message node here, same thing, same client ID or chat ID, operation send message, resource message. We structured this a bit differently. We said we received an email from the name. So like I said earlier, you just go to here, the from value, and then drag in the name. You can also do the email address. And it was labeled as customer support. So we're just letting us know that this was a customer support email and that a reply was sent. Finally, we're going to do the finance category. So we'll go into the text classifier and pull up the description for finance department. Emails related to budgeting, invoices, payments, payroll, reimbursements, financial reporting. These messages should be routed to the finance department for review or action. So let's copy this, paste it in. Okay, here's the message from ChatGPT.
Hi, can you please send over an updated invoice for last month's services? We need it for our internal processing and records.
Okay, so we can copy this, paste it in, and the sender name can be Jack. And we'll send this off. A few seconds later, we got the email. And if we go to the NAN, we'll trigger this. And the text classifier classified it as finance. Same thing here. You want to change this label from either support or high priority to finance. So go into your Gmail and make sure you have that label created. Choose it from the list. Then our AI model is going to create a summary of the email. So we can see we're sending in the subject and the text as a user message, like in the other two sections. But for the prompt, we're doing, you are a professional business assistant. You will be given the subject and text of an email categorized as finance. So we're telling it what it will receive. Your task is to write a concise summary that captures the key financial topic or action item in the email. Focus on important details such as amounts, deadlines, payment terms, or financial requests. So we're telling it to just focus on the essential things and create a quick summary. And of course, we want to output the content as JSON, the subject and the summary. The next step is a send a message. So this summary of the email is actually for our finance department. You can see we're sending a message not to who sent the email, but to a specific email that we define here, which is just my email plus billing at gmail.com. The subject, we drag that in from the last step. And the message, we also drag that in from the last step. I got an email that says invoice, request for an updated invoice for last month's services to be sent for internal processing open records. This email was sent automatically with NAN. Okay, if you want to get rid of that sent automatically with NAN, you can actually go back in here and do the append NAN attribution and trigger that off, and then execute the step again, and you'll see that that there's no attribution at the bottom anymore. Okay, then the last and final step was to confirm on our Telegram, and I did receive a message. Let's go look at it. It says, we received an email from Kyle Friel. It was labeled as finance department, and the financial department wasn't notified. Very good, very good. Okay guys, that's gonna do it for this video. I've actually implemented this workflow into my family business, and it has saved us so much time. There's many ways you can implement this into your business or to your personal email to save you a bunch of time. It's a great workflow, very powerful. If you guys like this video, leave a like and subscribe to the channel. And if you want this template for free, you can go to my free school community and download it there. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.